This is a net logo implementation of the elf Farol model that I described in the previous videos. This version is a slightly modified version of the one that's in the models library, and this one you can download from our course materials page. You can see that there's sliders here for memory size. That's how many weeks each agent can remember the attendance, the number of strategies each agent has, and the overcrowding threshold. So let's do setup. And we can see that there's 100 people, and here's the elf roll bar. And when we start the model, we'll see people deciding to attend or not attend each week. So let's start out by setting the memory size to 1. That is, we can only remember the previous week, and the number of strategies to 1. There's only 1 strategy per agent. Let's do setup again, and then we'll make the speed a little bit slower and go. This red line here is the overcrowding threshold of 60. This is the attendance over time. And this is the bar attendance. And this here shows the percent of days on which the bar is crowded. So we can see that if the memory size is only 1 and the number of strategies is 1, things are just terrible. The bar is always overcrowded. Okay, so let's try increasing the number of strategies. Let's see if that helps at all. Let's increase it to 10 and do setup. We still only remember 1 week back. And now we get this big oscillation where we go from, the bar goes from completely crowded to completely or almost completely uncrowded. The percent of crowded days is less, so we have an improvement, but you'd think that the population would be able to learn better what to do. So let's increase the memory size. Let's increase it to 5. Do setup and go. And things are getting a little bit better. The bar is never completely crowded. That is 100% of the people going there. The percent of crowded days is leveling off at about 48 to 49%. Okay, well, what if we leave this at 10 and increase the memory size to 10? So we remember 10 times back. Let's see if that improves things. Okay, so here we're getting a much better result in terms of the percent of crowded days and much closer attendance to just at the threshold, which is really what we want. So somehow when we have enough strategies and enough memory, the population as a whole, without communicating, with no communication among the agents, can get to a state where they're very close to the optimum. Where the optimum would be always having a non-overcrowded bar, but enough people so that it's right up to the overcrowding threshold without going over it. And you can see it's getting very close. The homework assignment will allow you to experiment with this even further. Let's recap what the elf roll model is all about. It assumes bounded rationality and limited knowledge, different from the assumptions of traditional economics. It includes adaptation, that is, the agents can learn from experience using induction. They observe past attendance values. They use that to decide what strategy to use at each time step. The learning isn't very sophisticated here, so you can imagine with even more sophisticated learning, the population could do even better. And that's something that you might want to try in the homework assignment. The question was, does self-organized efficiency, that is the best situation for all, emerge under these conditions? Well, we said the best situation for all would be if the bar was never overcrowded, but the maximum number of people, that is 60, would attend each week. And we saw that yes, to some extent, with a little bit of error, it does emerge. This is a proof of principle that Brian Arthur proposed to show that you could get such behavior without the very unrealistic assumptions of traditional economics. In conclusion, The Farol model has demonstrated that self-organized cooperation and efficiency are possible without the perfect rationality, complete knowledge, and deductive reasoning.